Hi, this is Venatori from Hate, and this is the Yogg-Saron encounter in 10 Man Olduar, Phase 1. In this video, we're first going to show you point of view from a tank, but then we're later going to switch to a ranged DPS. This phase consists of getting Sarah down to 0 health. She's not a hostile target, so you cannot attack her directly. However, the clouds that are spinning about her spawn adds, which must be DPS down near her because they have an AoE explode, which actually does do damage to her. It'll take about 8 to bring her down to 0 health. The explosions do substantial damage, so melee should try to run away when the add is around 25% health to avoid the AoE. The adds also have an ability called Dark Volley, which is an AoE damaging ability that does 8,500 to 11,000 shadow damage to the entire raid. It's not too hard to heal through, but the debuff it puts on you reduces healing effects by 25%. It lasts 10 seconds. The cast time is 2 seconds, so this should be easily interruptible by the melee or the tank. You can tell where the adds are going to spawn based on the way the clouds look. If they're big and glowing, like the one on the left side of my screen, then they'll spawn an add soon. The catch about this phase is that if any player, not including pets or totems, step into a cloud, or even touch the cloud, it will start glowing and spawn another add. Spawning one or even two extra adds isn't too terrible. However, any more than that and you'll quickly get overwhelmed. The adds spawn more frequently as time goes on, so accidentally spawning an extra add towards the end of the fight is more detrimental to the raid than if you spawned it at the beginning of the fight. Because of this, or just to make a speedier phase 1, you can intentionally spawn a few extra adds at the very beginning. However, I would not recommend this to any group who doesn't have phase 1 down pat. Each cloud moves down a set circular path at a fixed speed. So if you're zoomed out far enough and paying attention, you can predict the movement of the clouds and easily avoid them. Sarah has a few abilities that she can use during phase 1. One is called Sarah's Fervor. It increases a friendly target's damage by 20%, but also increases damage taken by the target by 100%. It lasts 15 seconds. Ranged DPS and healers shouldn't really worry about this buff too much. However, melee DPS need to make sure not to get hit by the AoE explosion of the adds while they have this buff on them. Another ability is Sarah's Blessing. It heals a friendly target for around 30,000, but then causes 60,000 shadow damage over 20 seconds. This needs to be healed through. Once Sarah is hit by 8 of the adds' explosions, phase 1 is over. The additional adds that are up need to be DPS down quick during the phase transition. This phase is all about control and awareness. The add needs to die near Sarah, the DPS needs to not pull off the tank, and everyone needs to watch out for the clouds. This is a video from the point of view from my ranged DPS. This is a separate fight from the first video. Thank you for watching the tutorial for Phase 1 Yogg-Saron. If you enjoyed it, or would like to learn about the Hate Guild on the Daggerspine server, please visit our website at www.h-o-d.info. And remember to be pro. Thanks.